More now on the latest stem cell research. At City of Hope, Dr. Karen Aboody is seeing exciting results in clinical trials with cancer patients. She's using stem cells to treat brain tumors.
I do stem cell research, novel approaches to treat cancer, invasive and metastatic cancer, with stem cells. And what we've discovered is that stem cells have brain stem cells have a natural ability to find invasive tumor sites in the brain. So if the surgeon cuts out the main tumor, the surgeon's going to miss invasive cells that have already moved out into the rest of the brain. How do you treat those cells without destroying the whole brain? So what we found is our stem cells, if we inject them in the brain, they will actually find those invasive tumor sites. So we are loading them with different therapeutic payloads to target the tumor cells with. We are looking at localized chemotherapy production so that you're only localizing the chemotherapy to the tumor sites and not the rest of the body. The way chemotherapy works is it gets administered intravenously, and it kills anything in the body that's dividing quickly. And the reason people lose their hair, have trouble with their skin, their bone marrow, is because these chemo drugs are toxic to anything that's dividing quickly, the tumor and your normal cells. So that's why there's so many side effects, devastating side effects sometimes that are just as bad as the diagnosis. What we want to do is, instead of giving the chemo through the whole body, give it, trigger the chemo only at the tumor sites. Therefore, you would only be hitting the tumor and not affecting the rest of the body. So we've actually just completed last month our first safety feasibility study at City of Hope that was about 15 patients. We injected the stem cells right into the brain, so we actually have proof of concept that the stem cells are converting the chemo locally at the brain tumor sites. I'm hoping to hit a home run here. We have gotten $18 million from the California Institute of Regenerative Medicine to go to clinical trial next year with another enzyme prodrug treatment. This is a drug used for many different types of cancer, ovarian, colon. We have preclinical data that show these stem cells will migrate to metastatic foci, metastatic cells that are in the lung, in the ovaries, in the bone marrow. They will also cross to the brain. One of the big problems with chemotherapy is it doesn't cross to the brain. It's prevented. Our stem cells can cross over. I discovered this about 18 years ago and was very passionate about it. There was a lot of negative comments about it at first, and people didn't buy into it. And sometimes the time has to come. And fortunately, after we published this work in 2000, many other labs have repeated a lot of the work with other types of neural stem cells. So it's not just the cell line that I have. Stem cells can be applied to almost any medical condition: diabetes, Alzheimer's, cardiac problems. Stem cells know how to make normal tissue. When you're an embryo developing into a person, these stem cells know how to make brain, blood, bone marrow, heart, liver. So what we're trying to do is take advantage of what they already know how to do. But can we take these stem cells, put them in an adult patient that has damaged tissue, and will the stem cells know how to regenerate the tissue or stimulate the body to heal itself? So many people are using it for regeneration. So when you stroke and you lose part of your brain, can you put brain stem cells in, and will they remake the brain and the connections? Very exciting. There's several trials with that right now. For our purposes, we know that they're pathotropic, that these stem cells find pathology. That's what they do. They want to try to heal, we think. And we just need our stem cells to go in, deliver their drug, and get out. A lot of people want them to stay to repair spinal cord injury. I think a breakthrough in any one field, in any one of these trials that are ongoing now, will make a huge difference and give the inspiration to keep going with the rest. But I definitely think that they're making a lot of progress with diabetes and with cardiac and Parkinson's. Something should hit soon, I hope. And we're all looking at each other's trials and learning from them. It's an exciting time to be a research scientist, and it's an exciting time to be in medicine.